For many years, users have been worrying about myths regarding their SSDs. A lot of users try to strain their SSD as little as possible, but these drives can actually write more data than promised by the manufacturer. Many brands of SSD can write more than 1000 terabytes in their lifetime. That is over 1 million gigabytes. In the past, Mozilla Firefox and Spotify have been accused of writing too much data to the hard drive. But while these problems have been fixed with patches, you can still do a few things to make your SSD live longer. Firefox can be configured to write less data by increasing the session restore interval. Open the site about:config and search for browser.sessionstore.interval. The default value 15,000 means 15 seconds, so a higher number would mean less writes to the drive. Make sure your BIOS is set to AHCI mode. Because SSDs can process multiple requests at once, IDE mode would limit the drive's performance. Unfortunately, IDE is often the standard setting. I know my BIOS always resets to IDE if it loads the default values. If you change an existing Windows installation from IDE to AHCI, Windows often gives trouble. So either change the setting before a new install, or boot in IDE mode and apply the registry fix linked in the description. Contrary to popular belief, you don't have to leave 10% free space when partitioning a new SSD. Some people argued this would increase performance and the lifespan, and even Samsung's SSD management software recommended this for a while. In reality, a SSD would still use that free space, whether you partition it or not, although it is smart to not completely fill up your drive. To avoid slowing down the SSD, consider buying a larger disk or watch my recent video on freeing up space in Windows. Most modern operating systems from Windows 7 onwards, macOS and most Linux distributions automatically recognize SSDs. Make sure the trim command is enabled and the SSD is using it. This way, unused data can be wiped internally. You should check, especially on older SSDs, if they support the trim command by using the software trim check. Don't defragment an SSD, Windows usually knows this by default. Windows also turns off unnecessary features like prefetch and superfetch, designed for slow drives by itself. While moving the page file from your SSD to another drive would clear up a lot of space, it would also slow down your system. I wouldn't recommend it. Some tuning tools try to turn off the Windows indexing service because supposedly it's not needed on a SSD. I wouldn't recommend this and other obscure fixes either, since you can't predict the effects on the system and it usually doesn't result in a significant improvement. Most manufacturers offer monitoring software for reading a drive's smart values, which is a nice way to get an overview over the drive's condition, but doesn't reliably predict a failure. You can also use universal tools like Crystal Disk Info, which aren't restricted to drives of a certain manufacturer, which is especially helpful if you don't use only one brand. Once a SSD is connected and partitioned, Windows usually does the rest. These drives are getting more and more advanced with every generation and correct errors by themselves. It doesn't hurt to check the smart values every once in a while. But most SSDs are swapped for a bigger model long before their death. If you're a power user with extra demanding tasks like photo and video editing, consider getting a pro model SSD with higher endurance. These will often write several million gigabytes in their lifetime.